Hey there, guys. So, a video for you. A few people have asked me album of the year, so I thought I'd do a video on my album of the year and show you some of my favorite albums that come out this year. There's been too many metal releases this year, and I've struggled to keep up with most of the bands. And I know a couple of bands I'm into. Some of their albums I still haven't got a hold of and gave a listen. So there's loads to go through, but I've picked up the majority of them, and I've added multiple collection of bands I've just discovered and various stuff. So I have a load written down on my laptop because, as I said, I've got a lot of boxes stacked full of CDs. Because when I move, because I'm looking for somewhere else, because I'm in a small room at the moment, and then I'll put them all on display. So I've written load down on the laptop, and these are the ones that I found. And then I'll get to the last part, which I'll show you my album of the year. I actually really struggled to find album of the year. There's that many releases that are released this year from all different genres. Power metal, symphonic metal, death metal, black metal. There's loads. Next year, I've already. There's loads coming out because there's a new Napalm Death album, the new Hammerfall album, the new Sabaton album, and then a load of other bands that have gone. Those are the ones off the top of my head, but there's some more releasing albums, so I will be doing videos on them, and I can't wait for them to turn up. So I've got a lot here, but I'll do the ones off my laptop first. First one was Tales and Legends, Struggle of the Gods. I played the hell out of that album. Absolutely fantastic power metal album. For anybody who doesn't know much about them, great power metal band. The name's gone straight up. Patrick J. Selby, that's it, is the vocalist of Bloodbound. He's on the album Tales and Legends and does the vocals. Perfect album. At the moment, on my group on Parasymphonic, it's going. Everybody's voted for it to be album of the year, which, for little small band, I was quite shocked, and I'm happily happy, because usually it's one of the biggest bands, so one of the big four or something like that gets album of the year. But for a pretty unknown local band, something like that is absolutely cool. Then we have Seven Thorns, Symphony of Shadows, another great album. I've played that album more times than you can shake a stick at, and I did really enjoy it. Then we have the second studio album by North Tail, Eternal Flame. This one doesn't feature Christian Eriksson because Christian Eriksson, after the first album, was booted. And I went into this album because, obviously, a new singer, and I was like, oh, not another band that have got a new vocalist. So it's trying to get into it, and I did enjoy the album. Thought it was pretty cool. Then the latest studio album of Ordenogon, Final Days. I actually got that album 2 months after it was released because of Amazon pissing me about, and I didn't give it that much love. I listened to it once, and I thought it was okay. And then I thought Heart of the Android and In the Dawn of the AI, I thought, was really good songs. And then after listening to it more and more and more, I started to appreciate the album more and fell in love with it. Then there's Iron Maiden Senjutsu. I have somewhere about. I think I packed it away. I have the big long box version. And most people, my friends on Facebook, most people slated that album and thought the singer was terrible, and they went prog, and they didn't like the way they've gone with the prog sound. But I actually enjoyed that. I fully, really enjoyed that album. So highly recommend it. That was a really good highlight of the year. Then we have Dark Throne, Eternal Hails. Such a great black metal band. If you haven't heard of them, I highly recommend them. I've listened to the album quite a few times. It was one of my favourite black metal albums of the year. Now I'll move on to the CD. Sorry about this, I've got a bloody bad cough at the moment. It just came back for some reason. We'll start off with this pile. Then we have Hosht and Grim, which is the latest studio album from prog metal band Mastodon. I actually really enjoyed this album. A load of people, for some reason, it was mixed reactions off a few people. I actually thoroughly enjoyed it. Then there was The Beast and Peace and Tranquility, which were my standard tracks off that particular album, which I did thoroughly enjoy. Then we have Torn Arteries, which was the latest studio album by Carcass. Great. They're from Liverpool. I believe it's Liverpool. You can get a version of this where you get like cutlery and plates, and I was having a good laugh with my friend saying, just imagine getting this album with the cutlery and the plates and everything, taking it out, and the moment you take it out, you dropped it by accident, the plate, and smashed it. I said, that's like total down the drain. You can imagine. And he fully agreed with me and laughed his head off. But I didn't get that version because it would never be opened and it's massive. And I thought it would probably take up way too much space. So I wouldn't mind getting it. It's just at the price and how big it is. I thought at the moment I can't really get it with this my room because it's small. But I do recommend that one. If you like your mellow death metal, then I do recommend grabbing that one. Then we have this one was released. I had it a couple of weeks ago and I've played it quite a lot and I do enjoy it. And that's Black Label Society, Doom Crew Inc., which is their latest studio album. Pretty good. I've said to people that, yeah, they're still on form. It's typical the sound of Black Label Society. And what was the track now? Forsaken and Set You Free was my standout tracks off that album. Then we have Worship, which was Hypocrisy or Hypocrisy. I'm not sure. Is it Hypocrisy? I'm guessing that's how you pronounce the name. Did enjoy the album. Listened to it various times. Do enjoy it. Children of the Grey and With the Walking Dead were my favourite standout songs off that particular album. Then we have The Quest. Actually really enjoyed this. Plus I did enjoy Leave Me Alone. And for 8 minutes and 5. And I enjoyed Future Memories. And that's the latest studio album, The Quest, by British prog rock band. Yes. If I'm right, they're from, is it the West Midlands? I think they're from the West Midlands. Well, a couple of people have mentioned, but I do enjoy them. Never seen them live. Wouldn't mind catching them live. I think that'd be pretty awesome live. Then we have another prog band, but this is a prog metal band. And the album is A View from the Top of the World, which is the latest studio album by Dream Theater. This album's a masterpiece. The last track, A View from the Top of the World, 20 minutes and 24 seconds. I played the hell out of that song and it's just incredible. All my favourite songs, most of my favourite songs seem to be songs that are on for like 20 minutes or something like that. Because I love songs with all the layered vocals and you get all the layered parts. And because the songs are on for like 2 minutes and something, usually they're over within 2 minutes and I can't really thoroughly enjoy them. But the ones that aren't for like 20 minutes, fantastic. Absolutely love them. So I was really impressed with that album. Then this one is Persona Von Grata. I think that's how you pronounce it. And it's the Exodus studio album. Great thrash metal band. If you love your thrash metal and if you like your Euro thrash metal and also your US thrash metal, I think you'd love this. But they are worth checking out. They are a great band. Prescribing Horror and Clickbait and also Slipping Into Madness was my standout tracks off this album. Some people have actually said to me before, so some of your favourite standout tracks is like the interlude, the 1 minute like intermission or something like that, and instrumental part. And yeah, I do like tracks like that. I do enjoy them, so I thoroughly enjoy all the album. This one's Spectra Overload. Highly recommend these. Prog, if you like your prog, obviously prog rock, prog metal, then I do recommend this. And Our Love was a good track off this album. Didn't mind the album. A couple of people I spoke to said they'd never heard of them. And I said, well, I'd highly recommend them giving them a go because good. What I heard of the album, great band. Then we have The Witches of the North, new Burning Witches album. Do thoroughly enjoy this. Most people are like, good power metal band. And I said, yeah. I believe they're from Swedish. I think they are Swedish power metal. I do have all their stuff on CD, but I know there's like, I think it's an EP or something that I'm missing on vinyl, and then I'll have all the stuff on vinyl as well. Then we have this one's, I believe it's German power metal. I think they're from Germany. There's that many bands release stuff that I do genuinely honestly forget where the bands are from. So say some are from Germany, some are from Sweden, and I do forget. So unless I say make notes on my laptop, which I didn't make notes, I should have made notes of where they're from and the genre and everything in case I get them wrong. But Apostolica, Heretica, Ecclesia, I think that's how you pronounce the album. I did struggle to pronounce this. And The Sword of Sorrow and No More Place in Hell is my standout off that, because I played that album, that song, more times than you can shake a stick, because I really enjoyed that. I remembered on the way from work to work the one day, because it's like an hour to work, I played that on repeat because I did really enjoy the album. This one's Eggy from Edguy, I think it's Eggy, or it's one of the members of Edguy, and it's Skyward, which is the Grandmaster. Great band. Debut album, did really enjoy it. Surrender, Skywards, Earthwards, Cannot Find the Way, Dead Bond. I do highly recommend giving that one a listen. Then we have the latest Rhapsody of Fire album. Fantastic. It's in one of my top 10 of this year, for definite. And I played Glorious is About for Salvation, The Kingdom of Ice, Abyss of Pain, and also the one bonus track, but I'm not going to pronounce it. You know, Per Leor, I think it's pronounced. It's in different language, but I did really enjoy this. Highly recommend it. It was a follow up to their last album, which was The Eighth Mountain, which I thought was a masterpiece. Getting to hear that full live was absolutely incredible. But that's another one. Highly recommend it for you power metal fans. Then this one was absolutely cool. It come up on Banger TV, and I listened to one song, and just from the one song, I bought the album. And my friend said, now I've got the full back catalogue. One of my friends said, I've got the full back catalogue to go through, and he's jealous because I get to listen to him. And this one's Where Fear and Weapons Meet, which is the latest studio album of 1914. Absolutely fantastic. The album's available for pre-order on Amazon out on January, and I think it's £27 something on January the 15th or something like that. And I've pre-ordered it because I do really enjoy this. So I thought I must get it on vinyl. Pillars of Fire, The Battle of Messinus, I think that's how you pronounce it. That was my favourite standout song off the album. I did, when I first got it, it's all I played was that track. I never gave the other album, the full album, It's Love, but I gave it more of a love, and I thought, yep, I do enjoy this. So Warring, FN380ACP, is it 19074, something like that, but I do recommend this album. I've said to a few people, give it a go, and it's a what genre. I've not told them. I've just said, going blind. I think you will be really impressed with this album. This next one's actually an EP. It's Mellow Death Metal, A Whisper of the Atlantic, which is Soil Work, their EP. This was out earlier in the year, but I didn't get it until, say, September, because for some reason I just never pre-ordered it on Amazon, and then it was in HMV for like £8, and I thought I need to get a copy anyway, and I need to give it a listen. But A Whisper of the Atlantis and Desperado were my standout on that, and I wouldn't mind getting that on vinyl. I'm going to see if I can get it, because it's a really good EP, cracking EP. This one is in my top five of album of the year, and it's absolutely fantastic. Can't fault this album. It's their first studio album. I've actually seen these live about four times. Yanis Papadopoulos is an immaculate singer. He could sing the phone book and he'd make it sound perfect. The album's Dark Connection, which is Beast in Black. I have done an unboxing video on this and the vinyl, because I do have the vinyl down there in my collection. Incredible album. Moonlit Rendezvous, and also One Night in Tokyo, and then hardcore standout songs off that album. So I do recommend giving this. And listen, some people are not really overly keen on power metal, but I say this album, band, you must give a listen. They mix of like synth pop and sort of 80s stuff into the music as well. It is highly recommended. So if you haven't listened to it, then I highly recommend it, because I'm going to play this again the moment I've done this video. I'll spin the vinyl again, because it's been one of my highlights of the year. Then we have Sermons of the Sinner. That's KK Priest, KK Downing's new band, with Tim the Ripper Owens and some of the various other members. Raise Your Fists has been my favourite standout song off this album, but I played it quite a few times. I did really enjoy it. It didn't get as much love as most of your albums that came out, because there's that many albums coming out this year, but I gave it a lot of more love later on in the year, and I've actually started to appreciate it more. Then we have the new studio album by Rage. This one's Resurrection Day. Pretty cool album. I've actually played Arrogance and Ignorance more times, the song off this album, digitally when I've been on the way to and from work, because it's my favourite track off the album, and I've played it the hell. I know they've got a new album coming out, because I had an email off Amazon saying a new Rage for pre-order, and I thought they've got like 24 albums out or something like that, so there's another one coming out, because they make like something like 2-3 a year or something, which they make quite a lot, and can't wait for it. So I do highly recommend this if you like your traditional metal from Germany. So I mean, if you like Accepts, Scorpions and that sort of thing, then I would give them a listen. This next one's a bit of core, if you like your metal core. And this is In the Court of the Dragon, which is the latest studio album by Trivium. I do really enjoy this album. This is in my like top 10. In the Court of the Dragon is a fantastic track. And then also the track Like a Sword Over Damocles, that's another great one. I was one point, I think it was like 2 weeks in a row, it's all I really played. I to and from work was this album on repeat, and I couldn't get enough of it, and I still can't get enough of it. So it's available for pre-order on vinyl finally, so gold vinyl. So I will be picking that up on vinyl, because I do want to get it. I do love the back catalogue, but I went back to these because after, I think it was, I'm trying to think of the album now, In Waves was a great album, but certain albums, they lost interest in me because I listened to the one album, The Crusade, and after that I just lost interest in the band for so many years. And then came back and this one was available for pre-order, so I thought I really need to listen to them a lot more. I gave In Waves a lot of a love, and I thought I've missed out on stuff over the years, certain stuff with them, so I thought I pre-ordered this album, and obviously wasn't disappointed. Now this album is their self-titled album, not their debut, because I've been going since the '80s, but this is their self-titled. This album is definitely a masterpiece, and it's in my top five. I can't believe it. It's got all the original members back, so Michael Kiske, Kai Henson, and obviously you get Andy Deris and some of the, you know, the original members, but it's the self-titled album by Helloween. This album, oh, is brilliant. Skyfall is fucking incredible. I've said to how many people, I cannot stop playing that song. When I first heard the promo video and the edit, I thought, whoa, this is cool. And then they said that's the edit version isn't the full version. I was like, I'm going to be treated to something spectacular with the full version. And I was. But the second, CD, you get Golden Times and Save My Hide. It was only till a few weeks ago that I actually started playing the second CD, because I never actually got around to playing it. I was playing the hell out of the album and just never gave love to the second CD, but after listening to it quite a few times, I do enjoy them two tracks off there, and I thought I'm really missing out on these. Then we have Existence Is Futile. I wouldn't mind getting this on vinyl, so I am looking for it, but it's a new Cradle of Filth album. Oh, this blew my socks off when I heard it, especially the Crawling King Chaos. I played that video dozens of times, and I was seeing them at Bloodstock the last time, and actually played Crawling King Chaos, a couple of the stuff off the album, and when they said this is new stuff off their new record, and after they played it, I thought this is really cool, I must get this album. I thoroughly enjoyed it, so I do recommend listening to them if you like your extreme metal. Then we have Call of the Wild, which is the new Powerwolf. When I first heard this album, I was like, eh, it was okay. It didn't grab me by the testicles or something like that. And I thought it was okay. It needed a lot more love. And I played it quite a few times. And there is standout tracks on the album. But their last album, I'm trying to think of their last album now. But their last studio album was absolutely incredible. I went to that tour. I seen like three or four shows or something on that tour. Bloody brilliant album. So I needed to give this more of a listen. So I listened to it more and more over this year and started to appreciate more of it. Then this Melodeath album, Swedish Melodeath, whew, grabbed me from the start, and I've not put the vinyl down. And it's The Nightmare of Being. The Nightmare of Being is a fantastic track, but it's the new album by At the Gates. Great Melodeath band. There's also, which I do love that, but my favourite off the album is The Paradox. I know with certain bands, with their albums, I can actually sit there and I can name songs, I can name this, that and the other, and then there's other bands. Somebody's like, what's your favourite track off the album? And I'm like, I know the song, but I just can't name the track, because I get like that with certain bands. Then we have Marco Girao, or is it Girao? Magic Opera, The Golden Pentacle. I had that with the t-shirt, not being able to put it down. in my top 10. I've said to everybody, it is a cracking album. So as long as well as that Tales and Legends, I couldn't put that down. But Elixir of Life, such a masterpiece. And then there was also Until the End of Time, which I thought was a great song off this album. But I've said to everybody, if you're on power metal and have not into power metal, have not listened to this, you must listen to this debut album. It will blow your socks off. Another album I thought was pretty good, which was Alliance, which is four. I actually thought it was one of the early albums reissued, but then I looked and it said it was a latest studio album. And there's Nephilim, Battlement, and Power Hungry, Rock Around the World, Queen of Spiders, and there's quite a few good songs on there which have, which grabbed me. So I do really fully enjoy that album. And after I thought, because it came up available for pre-order, and I thought, I've listened to one or two songs before, so I thought I really need to listen to them. Fully enjoyed it. I need to get their back catalogue and start listening to more of their back catalogue. Then we have Wall of Skulls, which is Brainstorm. For any of you German, more thrashy power, mixed traditional in, so they've got a mixture of everything. Where Ravens Fly was my standout track off this album, and obviously got the version with the DVD where you get a full gig from Germany 2021, but this one is 2021, so it's a full gig, which I thought was absolutely cool. I had to get the version with a full gig. Then we have Ad Infinitum Chapter 2 Legacy. I do have their first one because I did pre-order it and got it through, and I did an unboxing video on this. So it was ages ago I did the unboxing video, but this album is absolutely awesome. Inferno, Unstoppable, and Afterlife, featuring Neil, the one and only Nils Molin from Dynasty, plus he's also a member of Amaranth. So I actually thought that album, I thought, yeah, I've got to get that. And I said to a load of friends, it's a great album and it's definitely my top 20. I said, there's that many albums out this year that I've struggled. As I said, this next one, which is an honourable mention, Menorah, Brave the Storm. This popped up on, was it my Power Symphonic? Somebody posted it up and said that there's a pre-order link available for the new symphonic metal band. You get this studio album and a t-shirt. So I was straight on YouTube, checked one or two of the videos, whatever was available, and I thought, yeah, I pre-ordered it straight away, thinking it's definitely right up my street, and I've listened to it quite a few times. And Break Your Fall and The Traveller were my standout ones off that album, so I thought, I've got to get that. And then there was another one, this is another one that popped up on Amazon, and it was available for pre-order, and I thought, I don't know, Lost in Grey, Under the Surface, know nothing about them, but I did a YouTube, and it was sort of like symphonic slash folk, and I was like, this is definitely right up my street, and really enjoyed it. I played it a lot, and I said to friends, they must get a copy, and I've introduced so many people to this that they've absolutely enjoyed it. Was it Waves and Shine that I've played quite a few times off this album? Then we have another fantastic power metal band, which is, this album is the 121 Gigawatts Club. Where they're going, they don't need roads, and it's the new Skeletoon album. Great, fantastic power metal band. Holding On is my favourite one off here. But I know they do a cover of Johnny Be Good, Chuck Berry, which I thought was absolutely cool, because I do quite like covers. Now this one, this one's in my top three. I've not been able to put this album down. I've got the vinyl as well. I've done an unboxing video on this on my channel if you want to watch it, and for the vinyl and the CD. And it's Revolution by Walkings. If you love your power metal, yeah, but if you love your like Sabaton with your military history, but these have a certain theme, and you can probably tell by the theme, plus some of the tracks like Spartacus is incredible song. Then there's Ragnar, and We Are the Fire is a good song. So if you know, just by some of them songs and the artwork and everything, you probably can tell what the concept album of this is. I do have their full back catalogue, and I really want to see these live. So I am hoping to catch them on the next tour if they come to the UK. Right, these are the next two are my top two favourite albums. So I'll start with my second favorite album. I did struggle with these for album of the year, as I've said to a few people, I've fully struggled. There's too many good albums come out, and knowing me, once I've done this video, it'll be like, oh, I've missed this album, I've missed that band out, I forgot about this album, so I'll be kicking and screaming, thinking I forgot to mention, honourable mention to this album and that album, because when there's too many come out and there's too many to keep up with. But this one is a masterpiece, and it's Creatures of the Dark Realm, and it's a new studio album by Bloodbound. Oh, cannot stop playing this album. Marching to War, whew, The Power of the Ever-Burning Flame, which it's called The Ever-Burning Flame, but I absolutely love it. Then there's my favourite standout song off this album is Ever-Burning Flame, but I also like The Gargoyle's Gate and Marching to War. You actually get a full gig on the end of this, as a bonus DVD, because I noticed the last so many of Bloodbound, their Digipack, the extra stuff, is a full gig, same as Auden Hogan, where you get a full gig from like their earlier tour where they play stuff off said album, which I do really enjoy that, and I think that's cool when you get to hear live stuff from various album tours. I think that's pretty awesome. Now to show you album of the year. This album is, oh, I cannot stop playing it. It's when it first came out at the start of the year, I actually said to a few people that this band are very naughty releasing this album, which a few people said, how come they're very naughty? I said, they're just naughty for releasing a masterpiece at the start of the year. And I said, it's just bloody incredible. I do have it on vinyl and CD. I've done unboxing on both. I wonder if you can actually get it on cassette, but it's the new studio album by Dragony. The album's called Viribus Unitis. I think that's how you pronounce it. I know a few people said I've said it wrong when I've mentioned the album, because, you know, I butchered the name, but this is a bloody masterpiece. I cannot stop putting this down. So Siegfried Roy, you're very naughty for releasing this album at the start of the year. Such a naughty album to release. It's just incredible. Battle Royale has been my song of the year. I played that over 1,000 times since it came out, and I can't stop playing it. Also, there's a Golden Dawn, Cyber Joseph, such a fantastic song, but it's all got a certain concept, as you can see with the artwork. But somebody said, what's with the steampunk and the zombie and all that sort of stuff, and like the lasers and God knows what? And I was like, if you actually YouTube it, and it tells you a backstory, or there's a thing where somebody tells you the backstory of the album and that sort of stuff. But this is the coloured version anyway, so I've not been able to stop putting these down. But also Darkness Within, Love You to Death, God of War, but On the Blue Danube. Obviously the intro to this one, I heard the intro and I thought, bloody brilliant. They've done them proud, done the cover proud, so I cannot stop and I'll play this. So this is my album of the year, and it was very hard to beat. So many bands have came close, like Bloodbound, just by a whisker, went under it. And then there's obviously Halloween, Walkings and that sort of stuff. And obviously At the Gates and 1914, Carcass and whatnot. There's loads that have come close, but nothing has been able to, you know, pass this as album of the year. So yeah, that's been my album of the year. Hope the video wasn't on too long. I'm actually going to play that Dragony again, because it needs another listen, because it's such an incredible album. I hope you guys enjoyed this album of the year. I've got loads of unboxing videos I'm just about to do. About between now and tomorrow, I'm going to do about 30 of them, because I've got a load of stuff that needs unboxing and playing. So I'll be getting all them played and getting them out the way, because I'm back in work on a third. So I can't wait to obviously get them all out the way. So hope you guys enjoyed this. Remember to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell. I've got a hell of a lot more unboxing videos, and recommend a few people if you want to check out my channel, because they may find some unboxing videos they like. I always put a link in the description for the band, and I always mention about the band or what the style and everything. So if somebody's looking for my videos and they see, watch a video and say the artwork piques your interest or something like that, I might check them out because you'd enjoy them. I do run a group on Facebook which is dedicated to like Dragony, Bloodbound, Dream Evil, Halloween, Sonata Arctica, Hammerfall, that sort of stuff. It's power symphonic, so it's power metal, symphonic metal, epic metal, fantasy metal, neoclassical metal, traditional metal, and that sort of stuff, and operatic metal and whatnot, and it's all fantasy based because I'm a immensely huge power metal fan. So highly recommend joining that group and checking it out. There's music in there for everybody. So whether you like your traditional power metal, you like your over the top power metal, your fantasy power metal, or if you just want the straightforward stuff and the, you know, not the, as people say, the cheesy power metal, which I absolutely love, then there's various power metal symphonic, various stuff for everybody. So I'll see you in the next unboxing video. Take care, stay safe.